All right, guys. So we have a lot of people actually advancing into the round of eight, but unfortunately, they're all without an opponent. So it's like half of the round of eight's good to go. They're all just waiting for somebody to play. A little bit awkward in that regard. Yep. Kinky Mail says, can't you just contact YouTube Bay Street TV? Oh, Kinky Mail. You've been around so long. I love you so much. So I really don't want to be a dick to you about this. But no, you can't. And it's not that simple, unfortunately. It's very frustrating. YouTube in general has just become a shit show. Have you seen what they're doing with the whole age restriction thing, actually, Zombie Rob? Or have you heard about it?
I have not heard about the age restriction thing, but I have heard about the LGBTQ thing.
That is the age restriction thing.
Oh, is it? Oh, okay.
So what happens right now, if you guys don't know, like if you go to YouTube and you enable age restriction, it will basically remove content from channels that, that is outside of your age restriction. So if you're like a 15-year-old YouTube user and you can't see content made for 18-plus people. So if you go, even if you go to like our channel, which is 18-plus, you won't actually see any of our videos load. And for whatever reason, through coincidence or otherwise, like all of these like LGBT slash super religious slash super political channels have been branded as such. So everyone's just like, YouTube's trying to remove content, censor.
Yeah.
And everything has just like been a big shit show. And there's so many people way bigger than us that have been speaking out about it. And it's just, it's a mess. It's a hot mess.
Yeah.
Anyways, getting caught back up though. Thank you, Gnomeskull, for the 14-month resub. Le Jondette for 22 says WTF almost 2 years. And then Dumb Moments just now was a brand new sub. That's a great name. I like it. But yeah, YouTube's interesting actually. I was looking at this. So for example, there's a lot of really popular YouTubers who come to Twitch to stream, and some of them will get large viewership for it. Like I think when Philip DeFranco, like 2 or 3 years ago when he first streamed to Twitch, boom, like instant like 5k viewers, right? But then you got guys from, like, for example, Epic Mealtime. Everyone knows Epic Mealtime. Everyone knows Harley from Epic Mealtime. He's in other people's Twitch streams too all the time. I saw him streaming last night. He had like less than 100 viewers. And I'm just like,
oh,
what? And I'm thought, okay, I noticed he's streaming both through YouTube and Twitch. So my brain's like, well, streaming to both, obviously his audience from YouTube would be watching him on YouTube. So I go look on YouTube and he's got like less than 200 viewers there. So combined total of like 300 people watching him play for someone who has like literally millions of subscribers. Kind of blew me away. And watching this whole, if you guys haven't seen this either, there's been this whole like blowout thing with Destiny versus YouTube basically in the YouTube community. I'm not sure, like it feels like YouTube at this point, from what I see from all these people, is like you're either super fucking popular and super ultra rich, or you're literally, it's like the 1% thing actually. And everyone else on YouTube is just like trying to get to that 1%. And you know, the reason I bring up Destiny is because there's been a lot of talk about money and like how is this guy with like one of the big fights was like, how does this guy with 900,000 subscribers not make any money from YouTube, when really if you've got 900,000 people subscribed to you, you should be able to make some money from that, and blah 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 blah. You can go look into that if you guys want. It's actually an interesting discussion. I'm neither pro nor anti Destiny. It was just an interesting discussion because there's a whole lot of other shit that's been swirling around that dude lately. But I talk about this because I'm really glad we went with Twitch. I really actually don't know if we could be making the money we're making, much less have any success, if we were doing this any other way. So like right now we're not hitting peak viewership as I'm speaking, but it's nice knowing that like we can pull in 4k viewers when people bigger than us can't. It's nice knowing that like the StarCraft community is still alive when you're watching like these other YouTube communities just kind of like, yeah, there's like hundreds of thousands of views on these videos, but the content creators are still talking about how they can't afford to keep making the content. Like it's a crazy weird difference between the two worlds when I in my brain naturally just want to think, oh, they're basically the same, right?
Yeah, I think you would assume that they're the same, or that YouTube makes a lot more, because you hear about YouTube millionaires more than you hear about Twitch millionaires.
Yeah. Also, do we really have someone fucking trying to recruit in our chat channel right now?
Recruit?
Yeah, look at this guy in game. I mean, not in Twitch.
Oh,
he's like trying to do like a clan recruitment thing. Like, hello, these are people who have fucking teams, bro. Like, nobody in the Corsair Cup's looking for some random clan team. Like, I'm just, not to be a douche, but
that's interesting. We still don't have any matches available.
Yeah.
By the way.
So people do know who's waiting. It's going to be Risky versus Keen or Aravinic, so probably Keen. Mana waits for either Lycanine or Ziggy. Teela waits for either Jig or Black Lols. And Hush waits for either Night End or Solo. Honestly, I'm kind of most interested in seeing Hush's matchup versus Solo or Night End. Solo's a Zerg player who's actually not too shabby. Night End is, of course, Protoss. PvP could be interesting and fun. Either way, yeah, we're just kind of stuck in Limbo Land waiting at the moment.
Limbo Land. Not as fun as the game.
Cooking on Twitch is kind of new. Yo, I actually have lately been spending more time off of the gaming channels and more on like creative slash music slash cooking streams. And this guy was making stir fry on Twitch yesterday, right? Or no, sorry, I think it was like Friday or Thursday.
Okay.
And stir fry is like the easiest, one of the easiest things you can make.
Yeah.
I just sat there watching him, like, he puts the noodles in and then just doesn't touch them. Like, they just sit there in the block. And I'm like, mix the noodles. Just a little bit, please. God, don't just leave them there. They're not cooking evenly. Like, this is making me so mad.
yeah. I see people post on Reddit or, like, just talk in daily life and whatnot that say, like, they aren't good at cooking. And, like, on one hand, I can kind of understand, because sometimes they really mean it. Like, they know what their cooking level is, and they mean that they can never seem to make it taste as good as someone else does. And that's fine, right? But then I feel like some people actually genuinely think that they cannot, like, put things in a skillet and follow a recipe and make that recipe. And that I don't get.
Well, you know, it's funny. I was, my roommate, Kate, we were cooking the other night, and she's talking about how much she's like straight up scared of like gas stoves and doesn't like them and blah blah blah, right? I've never had a gas stove in my life, so I'm really excited and happy to have the open flame. But halfway through cooking, some like paranormal activity shit started happening that made me start realizing maybe she's justified in her hate and fear, because I've used our stove probably every day since I moved in. Never had an issue. I've cleaned it even, and I've had to put it back together, and I've never had an issue with it. I'm sitting on the couch while she's cooking something, and the lighter won't stop clicking. Like it's going like normal, and just out of nowhere, it's like click, 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 and it won't stop until I get up and I walk over there. And a second I'm like within 5 feet of the oven, it stops, or stove, it stops freaking out. I'm like, okay, that was weird, right? Go back to sitting down. She then tells me the story about like how she doesn't like it and blah 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 blah. Starts clicking again. And I look and I'm like, she doesn't have any settings wrong. You can't mess this up. It's just a knob you twist. I'm like, what's going on here?
Interesting. Do you want to cast Keen or Mana?
Honestly, the Mana. Let's go Mana.
Okay.
I think Mana and Keen. Well, Keen's probably going to likely take out Risky. Mana, I don't know much about Ziggy, but we haven't seen much Mana lately either. He is streaming his own point of view, by the way, if anyone would like to watch his first person.
I swear he was in the chat.
They may have started.
No, they didn't.
Then I don't know.
Or maybe he just AFK'd out.
Oh, he's in a game at the moment.
Or he's playing a game. Either one.
You in the lobby with his opponent?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. Maybe went to look at a replay or play a ladder game or something.
Yeah. If the gas thing, I've always had a gas stove. I can see why people would be afraid to use it, though, because I think I remember when I was really young, I was afraid to turn it on, like 6 or 7, and then I got used to it, obviously. But it's very helpful when the electricity goes out and you can still make stuff.
Yeah. Checking Mana's stream right now, but it's not loading for me, so I can't actually tell what he's doing. Okay, well, someone's also asking, is there a VOD of the Scarlet cooking stream? It'd be on her Twitch channel if there is. She was cooking with most of the other members of the house. Major was just kind of sitting there being a yuckster. Yeah.
He was like the popcorn gallery without the popcorn. Yeah. Caught very, very small bit of it.
Scarlet also, I would presume, doesn't like gas stoves, at least what I surmise from watching that stream.
Really? I must have missed something. I don't remember that.
Oh, because she almost like burnt the house down.
Oh, that's right. You said
hashtag real house on fire.
I still don't know how she did that. What do you? She might be a bit of a pyro, man. Like, we're in France. By the way, Mana's playing a ZDZ right now.
He's playing as ZVZ?
Yeah.
He's playing as Zerg?
Yeah. Yeah, he's usually warming up. So, we're in France. I blew out one of the candles that was on our table. Just because. And she, took, a great offense to that. So she, asked for the some other person's candle. And these are, really small candles, right? In, a glass jar. Not, a stick, right? It's, a jar. And she, want to do the whole make the fire go into the other jar and make the fire, but it won't work because if you ever tried that with jars, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
So she had a great idea and she ripped part of this napkin and put caught that
the
on
napkin
fire,
on fire and then lit the other one
and then lit the other thing. This is so unnecessary. You might just burning.
You know
things.
What else was unnecessary? You blowing out that candle, though, dog. Why you do that? You just being a troublemaker. Don't put
that
this
is
on
what everyone,
Scarlet.
That is what everyone said, actually. So, clearly, I'm just trying to twist the story.
Alright, so real quick here. Gotta give a big shout out to our boy Ziggy, who's about to play this game. He's got that How It's a Boot Time portrait. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nobody has his portrait. So, it's nice when you find someone else who does. And he's Grandmaster, too. So, it's not some random scrub. Hype?
Yeah. He did beat Lily Canine 2-0. That's always cool.
Yeah. We're going to deal with construction noise for this game, by the way, because it's getting really warm in my room, so I got to open the door.
Okay.
There is supposedly some air conditioning settings, but I can't figure out how to make them work, because no matter how much I churn down the heat on the thermostat, it still stays the same temperature.
It's the Korean hotel all over again.
No, that was BS. Until we figured out about the floor thing, I was so mad. It's thank you to Sven Ninja for the Twitch Prime sub. I'm sorry for the delay, guys, but yeah, we're waiting on Manus. We're going to go to a commercial break, I guess, and hopefully he'll be good to go in 2 minutes. All right, so we actually have a bit of shenanigans right off the bat, spawning here in the bottom left, but not entirely staying at home. It's going to be the yellow Terran contender, Ziggy.
In the bottom right, is the red Protoss. He is liquid mana.
I love this guy in chat, by the way, who's like, Zongrip, you do know we have lighters in Europe, right?
Oh, no one had a lighter.
I love, because that was kind of the tone of the story. It sounds like, oh, we didn't know what to do, how to make fire, had to grab a napkin, no other options.
I wasn't the one that, wanted to light it up again.
Rip in pepperoni, Ziggy. Bro.
Yeah.
Although, Rip. You know, the SCV's got some sick RNG for him right now. If he stays there long enough, hypothetically, he could finish that barracks.
What? No. Oh, well. Okay, he's not even going to try. Oh, well. I wanted to see RNG on his side. So, it is a very awkward opener. Technically, you can play through it, but it actually delays your build, 2 minutes or something extreme. So it's usually not. You will occasionally see something like this actually turn into an instant GG by people who need to just get over the game, I guess, best way to put it. Just need to get it out of their mind and go into the next game. But Ziggy's gonna try and play this through.
Well,
very unfortunate.
While we were staring at this awkwardness that was on the side of the map, he did immediately throw it under the barracks back at home, though. So it's. Mm-hmm. Maybe not going to delay this nearly as bad as it normally does, because usually we see when this fails, people fight that out and they'll keep trying to put that barracks down and they'll bring more SCVs with it and kind of ends up being a fruitless endeavor. This is awkward and still forcing him to be a little bit behind, but maybe he can get some magic done. Likely, no, but we'll see if he can pull it off. He's got the Hell to Boot Time portrait after all, so I am cheering for him.
Yeah, plus 10 of luck. That's why... That's why the SCV had good RNG. The Reaper's gonna scout this probe, but as I said, it's very awkward timing. He got the factory first, so that's the good news, is that he will be able to get a Cyclone, as Mana does try and pylon rush him here. But he went for Reactor instead. Okay. this is just actually so awkward, because he had to cancel the... He knew his Flooding was gonna die if he left it there. But he needed the supply to start a Cyclone. So now his other two supply depots are really late, and he can't start a Cyclone. So, yeah. There it is.
Oh, and that SCV is low, so it's not going to finish the command center, maybe?
Oh, the adept should have gone for it.
Yeah, he recognized it now, but... Oh, no! So close!
Yeah. If it could take one shot, it would be worth finishing the command center, but it can't even take one shot. Boom!
That sucks. Luckily, though, the weird irony here is by having canceled everything and being delayed the way he was, he actually doesn't have that much to lose at the ramp, but...
It's like getting like mugged, and you're like, ha, joke's on you. I only have $5.
I already got mugged, idiot.
Oh, God.
I think I'll be able to save the command center, but this is certainly annoying. You have to wait out that pylon.
It's a little dangerous, though. If you figure an oracle's on the way, and you try and break it, and the oracle swoops in with three adepts, it could be bad news. Because well, now it is three adepts.
Three depths are not for the moment. He does start up a third CC, so even if he's forced to cancel this one, at least he has something else going for him. But
yeah.
The adepts are going to ideally just draw the attention here to the natural while they actually transfer through to the main. And yeah, oracle on the way, adepts distracting on the other side. Ziggy, if Mana was playing sloppy, Ziggy could easily hold this off, but Mana's not playing sloppy.
I think it's a lot of damage.
Yep.
GG.
GG. All right, Mana takes game number one. Poor Ziggy.
Yeah. Ziggy was naming my cat.
Do you think this guy was just like a big fan and named himself after your cat?
No, I don't think that.
No.
Maybe his name was Apollo and he had Hell's Foot Time Portrait, but no one was a fan of Ziggy, I'm sorry to say.
Well, in fairness, I don't think we ever saw Ziggy, right? I don't think I ever even saw Ziggy at the picture he sent me.
Probably picked him up once or twice because he did used to hang out in my room, but then he stopped. Yeah. We're probably going to get another one, though. You guys ready to be so excited for when I have kittens? I'm going to put them on stream so much.
You mean when you get kittens, right?
What did I say?
When I have kittens? Because it's not like you can give birth to like a litter of kittens. Like, I'm an actual cat mom, guys.
Okay, I guess if you want to... All right, fine. Yes, when we adopt some kittens.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah, we're going to start, I think the plan is to start looking after Ting, so very excited. Go! Kittens!
Alright, well, joining off the lobby, what map do we have here? Cactus Valley. Ready to go whenever the players are.
Beep-boop.
Alright, so what's the bracket shaping up elsewhere? Looks like Jig advanced to fight against TLO, so that's a ZBZ going on the other side of the round of eight. Hush plays against Solo, so that's ZVP. Keen is the last remaining Terran other than Ziggy, it would appear.
Huh. Alright then.
Spawn here in the upper right, playing for Team Liquid, and up 1-0. Currently, it's going to be Team Liquid's Mana.
In the bottom right is the yellow Terran. He is Ziggy.
It's a good thing Mana chose to scout that game, too, because it is worth noting, if Ziggy had actually gotten away with the proxy and then followed it up with like a proxy factory into even something like a proxy starport, like that game could have gotten messy for Mana. But that was,
yeah, it could have.
Very much so shut down right from the get-go.
Yeah. I mean, even if it had finished and you scouted it, still great. You know, you can actually adapt your build and your way of thinking about the game to compensate for it. And if he hadn't scouted it at all and just played very, like, you know, normal slash greedy, then there's still a chance that you don't take damage, of course. But and that was just a series of unfortunate events. Because in a perfect follow-up, you can finish that command center and then you cannot take that much damage from the pylon. And you're prepared for the oracle, and yeah, you're still in a bad position because everything is delayed by like a full minute, but you still have a chance that Mana would mess up. That wasn't the case. I mean, the good news is Ziggy has a second game to actually play a macro game and show us what he's got.
Show us what you got.
I expected nothing less, Rifkin.
I really want to just get like some sort of prepared reaction meme. Anytime either of us say that, it just pops up automatically on the stream with a giant head. Just like shakes violently. But okay, Mana coming into the natural. As a side note to that, actually, I've had a really bad luck of finding other people who like Rick and Morty. Or not, rather, I phrase that, it sounds like people dislike Rick and Morty. But what I mean is, like, I'll go to a party and I'll be like, dude, do you watch Rick and Morty? And they'll be like, no, I've heard so many good things about it, but I haven't seen it yet. It's on my to-do list. Like, that sort of thing. And finally, after, like, so many times doing this, this party I went to last weekend, I met this girl. If I remember her name was Sarah or something, I don't know. She was fun to talk to, but she had all this nerd swag on, and I was just kind of talking to her about, like, her Zelda necklace. And then I noticed, as she shows me her necklace, I'm like, stop, what's that underneath your necklace? She's like, huh? And she's wearing, like, a Rick, like, ugly Christmas sweater. I was like, oh, do you like Rick and Morty? So here we are at this party, loud music, everyone's dancing, whatever. I should probably be hanging out with my friends. Instead, I met this random stranger. We just talked about Rick and Morty for, like, 15 minutes in the corner of the room. Good times.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. That's like a good party.
Well, I spent the first 15 or 20 minutes watching GSL and eating chicken, so it was a great party, to be honest.
We also met those StarCraft fans, right?
Yeah. Oh, okay, so I don't know if I told this on stream or not. I know I told you about it, but, you know, whatever for StarCraft's a dead game, right? I was sitting there at the party eating my chicken, whatever, and these, like, two guys walk by, one of them bumps into me by accident, says, sorry, and no problem. And as they start walking away, I hear them talking about, and I think I heard them say Flash or Jadon. It was some Brood War player name, though, and I was like, wait a minute, you guys like StarCraft? And they're like, yeah, we're just talking about Brood War. And I'm like, oh man, come sit down with me. Let's talk about this. So we sat down, but eventually went outside, and we're just talking about StarCraft for a while, which was kind of cool. I've never had that happen. I've never met another person in British Columbia, at least, that wasn't already like a Bay Street TV fan that was into StarCraft. Everyone's always like, isn't that game dead? Who is it dead? Is it Counter-Strike or Dota?
Okay.
But no, it was really cool. It was a weird experience. And while I don't personally care too much about Brood War, it was just nice to find somebody else who liked StarCraft for once.
Yeah. Well, Mana has a very interesting wall here. This is like, speaking of Brood War, it's very Brood War-esque. Kind of cool. And his Stargate was scouted, but that's like kind of the least of Ziggy's concerns, really. You see a Stargate, the Oracle initially is like problematic, maybe, but it's really about the follow-up. This Adept Phoenix style has been killing many a Terran.
Yeah, Neve made it look really good recently after having a bad series versus Gumiho and just kind of highlighting how good it can work even against Koreans. But Mana playing very carefully around the Mineral Line. Unfortunately, he was distracted, so one Widow Mine hit over there, another in the main. He pulls at the last second, but still ends up losing more probes than Ziggy lost SCVs.
Yeah. That could have been a lot worse, but it should have been a lot better. Just the timing of the medevac was that perfect. The Adepts moved out to the Hellions, the Phoenixes weren't quite out. I mean, that doesn't usually happen. And you will lose the medevac for it. So it's always that question of, like, unless I get a really good hit, which six probes is pretty good, is it worth the medevac?
Well, Phoenix coming in onto the natural. Unfortunately, there's a turret down, so it won't be super easy kills for the Phoenix, but the Adepts are going to have no problem.
Oh, is this game?
Not if Mana doesn't go to the main. Shoot. If Mana went to the main and camp production, yeah, you could argue, right? It might be. But the tank's coming out now, and there's several Marines out. The tank would just be lifted, of course. Like, the tank is not really an element in this equation.
Exactly. Like, I imagine the scenario in my head where, like, he kills the two Marines that just popped out. There's only three other Marines otherwise. The Marauder eventually gets picked off, too. If there was a war prism, it would be. But this is mild harassment, but really it should have just been a poke. So, like, no matter how you look at it, it's bad news for Ziggy having to retreat like that. At least he got another Widow Mine drop off.
I think it's the same Widow Mines from before.
Was it?
Yeah, only two died.
Huh. Yeah, okay. Maybe the one move.
I think Mana, yeah, he moved him, but also I think Mana just didn't have the Oracle till just now with the energy to reveal on one, and then the other had the cannon built on it, so.
Yeah.
Alright, a little bit of payback for Ziggy, but he's still behind in workers, and no third CC on the way while Mana's third Nexus just finishes up. This will be really easy to saturate, too, with that nice, nice Chrono Boost. It's a big boy Chrono Boost. For a big boy Protoss.
I said a big boy Chrono Boost.
I'm trying to make light of it.
I think a big boy Chrono Boost is that thing in co-op. Actually, like,
well, first off, you would be correct in that, but I was gonna say a big boy Chrono Boost would also be like anytime Parting does like a Chrono Boost.
Big boy Parting.
Yo, he's been streaming again lately. I don't know if anyone's caught this, but he's been doing a couple of streams here and there with like very, very few viewers, because I think people don't know about it.
Really great Phoenix usage. Also very questionable that Ziggy didn't bring the tanks with his push. I mean, it's Cactus Valley and getting across the map is the first difficulty, but if you can and you siege the tanks up, it's actually kind of difficult.
Well, the base over here is a little bit in trouble, maybe. The Adepts aren't that good to defend initially, but there's so many Phoenix that could probably pick up the Marines.
Yeah, they do, but only after 8 probes died. I mean, certainly a mistake here by Mon not to have a pylon over there or the mothership core to overcharge.
I like that he gives chase to the medevacs and just lets everything else clean up the ground. I mean, yeah, that kind of sucks for Mana, but he's... Like, Ziggy right now is still not even evening the playing field with this. Like, he lost the 2 tanks at home. It's going to be even tougher pushing forward. It's like, I think... As good as the damage looks for Ziggy, it's still barely scratching the surface of what Mana really has.
Yeah. I mean, this is not the cleanest game for either player, but Mana is still getting the better trades, I think, every single time. He's going to pretty quickly go over into Robotics Bay as well, so not stay too long on Adept Phoenix. Although, I think if he wanted to, he could actually win the game just by massing. I mean, it's about 2 tanks. There's no wall. There's no Widow Mines.
I do like that Mana's playing it safe, though, and he's still going for the Robo, and he's not going to try and dive too deep and throw the game away, as we've seen players do in the past. In the meantime, though, big thank you to all the StarCraft badness for the 3-month resub. It says, hey, I've met 2 StarCraft fans randomly at parties. Nerds are out there, right? Hell yeah. Then, brand new Twitch admin, whose name I haven't seen before. How you doing there, Joe? Joe?
Hi, Joe.
Joe Nerve says, I saw a guy yesterday in Whole Foods with the coolest SC2 t-shirt, hashtag not a dead game. But now we're going to make fun of you for going to Whole Foods, so...
Ha! You hipster.
Well said, who else subbed us before that? Yegazul, SE2, 14 months. Says, hey guys, every month my wife calculates what it could be bought with the money I make to give... the money to make me give up supporting you, so I never calculate it. Nice! Irresponsibility at its finest.
Nice. Also, note, I go to Whole Foods occasionally. They do actually have some good things.
Oh no, it's fine. I was just making... I think we had the Whole Foods in Toronto. I went to a couple times too.
Yeah, it was the closest, but it really is an entirely different store. This is not the difference of like Giant, Harris Teeter, which is the same grocery store. Very, very slight differences. This is like, I don't know.
Yeah, at the end of the day, I'm still Team Safeway though, and Team Costco when it comes down to it.
Sure. Yeah, I think everyone likes Costco. Safeway used to be around here, but it's not anymore. But yeah, Whole Foods was like. Yeah, it's a lot of different brands. Anyway, this time the tanks are around, but the Marine's gonna trigger this.
Triggered! Oh, wait, hang on, where's the, triggered! There we go. Appropriate camera movement to go with the meme. He does focus on the Colossus pretty quickly, and that's nice to see, but so much of his army being enabled, or disabled, enables Mana to win. GG. Well, that's gonna be nice for Mana, so he does go on to fight against Keen, and this actually timed out really nicely for us, so we won't be waiting around for long. First map is going to be on Honor Grounds in the semifinals. Also worth noting, everybody who makes it to the semifinals does make a little bit of cash, but also those points to get to the season finals. We're going to go to commercial break though, 2 minutes. Stick around, guys. We'll see you soon.